God is good.
All the time.
Another time.
Another day.
Dear friends, today is the first Sunday of Advent. The church today begins the new liturgical year. From the first Sunday of Advent, the church begins a new liturgical year. And we see the Advent wreath representing the 4 weeks we have in Advent before Christmas. The four candles represent the 4 weeks we have in Advent before Christmas. And when we talk about Advent, what do we mean? When the church comes together to celebrate the Advent, what the church is trying to celebrate? We look at the word Advent. The etymology of the word Advent comes from the Latin word Adventus. Adventus, which means arrival. When you go down to another meaning of it, the verb of the word Advent in Latin word comes to be advenire. Advenire, which means to come. To come. Jesus coming. Jesus coming in flesh. The commemoration of the birth of Jesus Christ. That is why when you go to the church's teaching and also to other religions, you see that there are so many churches that observe Advent as a time of expectant waiting or a preparation of both the celebration of the Nativity of Christ at Christmas and also the preparation or the celebration of the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, which we call the Parousia. But Advent in general is a time of expectation, is a time of hope, is a time to prepare, to be alert, to be awake, to get ready, to receive the child Jesus. Not just to commemorate the child Jesus, to receive it in our hearts, in our families, to bear the mark of the image of Christ in our life. And so the message today is a message of hope. The first reading taken from the prophet Isaiah, the prophet prophesied to the people of God to hope in God, to trust in God, to always know that on that mountain the Lord will bring everything, will reconcile everything that has brought dissension among them. He said, nations will no longer threat war against nations. On that mountain, the Lord of hosts will bring together every people from all corners of the world. And he said, let us go to that mountain, to the mountain of the Lord, so that we may get instruction. That is the message of hope. That is the message of expectation. When we talk about hope, what comes to your mind? Hope is one of the theological virtues that we cannot do without as Christians. Without hope, we and I will not be here today. Hope being a theological virtue, all of us, each and every one of us, are called to imbibe the virtue of hope. Because in hope, we expect. In hope, we kind of demand what God has in store for us. So the prophet prophesied that message of hope to them, for them to know and to believe that the Son of God is coming, their Redeemer is coming, and is close at hand. And when we hope, we don't just hope without getting prepared. When we hope, we prepare ourselves. In preparing ourselves, we try to be awake and be alert. That is what the gospel reading is talking about today. Let us prepare ourselves. For we do not know the time the Lord will come. But when we talk about preparation, what kind of preparation is the church calling us to do at this time? We prepare ourselves for so many things. We decorate our houses. We get Christmas trees, get Christmas trees. All these things are preparations. But the church is calling us in a special way to prepare ourselves to get ready. The inner preparation is the basis for this celebration. To prepare ourselves in a life of holiness. To prepare ourselves in love. To prepare ourselves in togetherness, in forgiveness. To prepare ourselves in charity and kindness to one another. That is what the church calls us this morning to prepare ourselves. And also the church also calls us to run away from the things, to avoid the things that will be tantamount to us getting ready to welcome Jesus Christ in our hearts. The church calls us to be careful of those things that can be a block, a stumbling block in our lives. What are those things? And that is what St. Paul is telling us in the second reading today. St. Paul, writing to the church in Rome, tried to remind them that it is time to stay awake. It is time to give out the time of darkness and put on the armor of Christ. It is time to avoid all kinds of evil deeds. And he mentioned some of them. He said, it is time to run away from drunkenness, promiscuity, envy, jealousy. He mentioned a lot of them. This is the time. As we go, as we prepare, we are called to get prepared and avoid anything that be tantamount to the life of holiness in our life, especially this time that we are anticipating the coming of Jesus Christ in our hearts. And so, dear friends, the message is, as we prepare with this first Sunday of Advent, let us look in our hearts. Let us constantly express our hope in God. Let us not lose hope in Him. Let us not give up on Him, because He will come to restore us again. I don't know what you are passing through, but what I know is that our hope cannot be in vain. When you read the book of Proverbs, chapter 10, verse 28, it says that the hope of the righteous brings joy, but the expectation of the wicked lest we perish. When you read Psalm 33, verse 18, it says, behold, the eyes of the Lord is on those who fear Him, on those who hope in His steadfast love. When you read Proverbs chapter 23, verse 18, the Word of God says, surely the future will come, our hope will not be cut off. I don't know where you stand today, but what I want to tell you today, in this first Sunday of Advent, that our hope in God will never be cut off. Our hope in God will never be in vain. We are waiting because we know it must surely come in our life. Let us today rejuvenate our hope again. Let us today rejuvenate our trust in God again. Let us refill ourselves with the hope of Christ coming in our midst, so that we can be able to wait for Him in strength, wait for Him in good deeds, wait for Him in all that we have, so that at the end of everything we can say to ourselves, Lord, I have waited for You, and here You are, You have come to bless me. And so let us ask the Holy Spirit. We cannot do it alone. Let us ask the Holy Spirit to strengthen our hopes. Let us ask the Holy Spirit to always be there for us, especially in this Advent season, so that we will be strong and never let go of anything. We invite the Holy Spirit to strengthen us as we sing this song. Spirit of the living God,
Mothers, fear. salvation.